Everybody, this is Bobby with bobbystamps.blogspot.com. I'm going to show you how I made this cute card using the diaper wipe technique, and I just love the colors and how the card turned out. I am going to change it up a little bit in the video. I just wanted to see. I'd never tried that technique before and decided I would try it tonight, and I wanted to see if I was going to like it. And I don't want to waste my supply, so I'm just going to do it with you guys on the video, and I'll show you how I changed it up. So I don't know if any of you are familiar with the diaper wipe technique, but I just took a paper plate, I took two diaper wipes and folded them in half, and then I dropped ink from Mossy Meadow, Blackberry Bliss, Lost Lagoon, Tangelo Twist, and Hello Honey. And you kind of do them close, so that way you do want them to kind of run together. And I just wanted to show you really quick how I did that. But before we get to the card, I just want to share something with you that I posted on my blog. It's about my Garden in Bloom class. So anybody that signs up for my Garden in Bloom class before next Friday, which I think is May 3rd or 6th, I can't remember now. I think it's the 6th. We'll receive a free stamp set from me, and these are all the Celebration stamp sets. I have a ton of these because I ordered so much stuff from that. So you will either get Hello Honey, and That Chick is to Die For, Botanicals for You, Flowering Fields, Sky's the Limit, What I Love, Party Pants, and Petal Pusher. So you will receive one of those in your class kit from me. And if you just go to my blog, it's bobbystamps.blogspot.com. There's information on there. I think the class total is $56. You get the ink pads, the stamp set, and one accessory that you'll get that you get to keep. And then the other accessories, there's two more accessories that I didn't want you guys to have to buy. So I'm providing those, and I'm providing all the cardstock. And you're going to have four different designs, and you will get enough cardstock to make two cards each. And I'm only going to show you a really quick peek of the cards, and it's going to be quick because I want you guys to be surprised when you get the class kit. So here you go. There's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So those, and I'm just going to give you a little bit more. This folder, our card is actually embossed, the banner, and that's the little pearl that you're going to get, that you will actually get to keep. So let's move on to our card. Enough about that. So if you have any questions, just let me know, guys. It's a fun class. I'll email you the link to a private YouTube video that you can watch at your convenience. You can watch it over and over again. And like I've said before, it's a great way to build up your stamp set and your ink pads as well. So for this card, we're going to use the Blackberry Bliss, and it's scored at 4 1/4. We're going to use Pure Pizzazz, and that's the difference, was I didn't put the Pure Pizzazz in the layering, and we're going to do that on this one. And of course, our Whisper White, and then I already did my little bow, because you guys, if you've watched my videos, I don't do very well at bows. So you're going to need the Pure Pizzazz ribbon, and these are all on the retiring list, and Blackberry Bliss ribbon too. So, and then Pure Pizzazz, I believe I cut this one at 4 inches and this one at 3 inches, and this is going to be for a sentiment. And this stamp set that we're going to use is the one that I won at Onstage, and it's, everybody got this, so it wasn't just me, everybody got this. And it is a beautiful, beautiful stamp set. I have another video that I'm going to do, hopefully tomorrow, using the same stamp. Because I don't know if you guys heard, but we now have embossing powder, bronze embossing powder, and I already did the card with it, and oh my god, I'm in love with the bronze embossing powder. And you guys can order this, the stamp, not maybe not this one, but in the new catalog that's coming out June 1st, if you sign up to be a demonstrator, May 3rd, we can order certain items out of the catalog. So if you're interested in being a demonstrator and you have questions, just let me know. I would love for you to sign up and be on my team. It's great. We would have a lot of fun and we would have fun stamping together. So we're going to use that one. And then for our sentiments, we're going to use Starburst Saying, and we're going to use your... Okay, guys, so what we're going to do is we're going to take two diaper wipes and you simply fold them in half. Just lay them on top of each other. And then you just start with your ink refillers. And you just randomly place drops. And that was the Tangelo twist. And you want them to run together. You want a little bit of white space in between them. That one was Lost Lagoon. This is our Mossy Meadow. And we'll just do some in the inside. And you want them to run together, so you do want a little bit of white space, but you also want them to run together. So I'm just going to go back in and randomly fill in. Okay, and that looks good. So that's basically all you do, and you're going to see my mess up there on that side when we go to put my glue dots on or my adhesive. So then you just take your stamp, and you want to make sure that you get the whole thing stamped up. I'm going to move this so I get a better grip. And this is where I'm going to change it up a little bit. I'm going to just kind of bring it in. Isn't that beautiful? I just love this. I'd never tried this technique before. And then you just make sure that you're getting the whole pad inked up. And then I'm just going to do one off. And then we'll turn it this way. Do one there. Isn't that so pretty? And you can kind of see down here that I didn't get enough of the ink on the stamp, but that's okay. I'm going to just put that back in the bag really quick. This is a really quick card. I'm just going to make sure that when I flip this, we'll just put this that towards the bottom and we'll cover it up. We can always fix our mistakes. This is a super quick card to put together. Just use our bone folder, and then we're going to adhere, if I can find my snail. This is the Pure Pizzazz. And then we'll just lay that on our card base. And then we're going to go ahead and take our Blackberry Bliss ribbon, grab my snips. And you just need enough to cover up the back. And then I'm going to use my trusty cheater method with the tape. And then I always like to flip it over and make sure that I have that pretty straight. And then just tape that down. And then for our bow, I used a glue dot. And I just put a glue dot. You can put one on, oops, one on each side if you choose, like I'm doing. Or you can put one right in the middle. Really doesn't matter. It's whatever you guys decide to do. I just love these colors together. It's just so pretty. Okay, and then for the sentiment, we're going to bring this back in because I stamped it with the multicolor too, and you just run it back and forth. Make sure you're getting it inked up well. Make sure that I have that. Yep. And then kind of do it in the middle because we want to do the little design on the end. And I got that totally crooked. But you know what? I'm just going to flip it over and we'll do it again. Okay, let's ink that up. Try it again. Much better. So when I do this, I just take my fingers and I try to get as centered in the middle and then off to the side to give it the little tail. I'm not sure what the technical name for this is. I'm sure it has a name. I just don't know what it is. And then just snip it. And you know what? It doesn't matter if you don't get it even or it's perfectly squared, because that's what makes these cards so unique, because they are, and then I just held, they're handmade. No two are ever going to be alike. I just held this one like this when I did. And I'll have to dig that out of my ink. That just went in there. I should have moved that. Should have known better. Okay. And then just clip it off. And then I don't want to get my fingers inked up, so I'm gonna, there we go. Move that away. Okay. And then we're going to get our dimensionals. And we're going to put 1, 2. And then just center it on the pear pizzazz. And then I used snail for the back of my card. You can use fast fuse if you want to because you have the ribbon, but I'm fine with snail. And then we're just going to, and I love it, I can tell you right now, better with the pear pizzazz on the white background. And then for this one, I'm actually going to use 3. It's because the banner is just a little bit longer. Sometimes I have the hardest time getting the back off those things. And I want to stick to my fingers too. And then we just put it on right onto the ribbon is what I did. What do you think, guys? You like it? If you like it, make sure that you hit the subscribe button and the thumbs up button for me. And if you have any questions about the Garden and Bloom class, just visit my blog and you can send me an email, leave a comment. And remember, you will get a free stamp set, one that I showed you from Celebration. And again, here they are if you're interested. I will include one in the order and you get 4 different card designs and enough card stock to make 2 of each design. So that's 8 cards. So thanks for watching the video today, guys. And if you have any questions, just let me know. Bye.